Hi there, this is Richard Walker from Lucidate, and today we're about to take a step into the future. Ever wondered how artificial intelligence could mimic the brainstorming capability of humans and solve complex problems? In this video, we will explore this exciting frontier through the lens of Tree of Thoughts. Large language models have been trained using vast amounts of text data. They make use of the transformer architecture of neural networks. They have been designed for tasks like text summarization, creative writing, and machine translation. They have not been explicitly designed to solve mathematical problems. Nevertheless, they've shown remarkable and frankly unexpected capabilities to solve limited but non-trivial math problems. Beyond a certain size, these large language models have also demonstrated an ability to continue to acquire new skills and capabilities. With a well-designed prompt, it's been shown that they can improve their performance at inference time. Understandably, this has raised interest in an entirely new discipline, a discipline known as prompt engineering. Within this discipline, new and reliable techniques of prompting large language models have developed. Previous Lucidate videos have examined several of these techniques, including chain of thought, self-consistency, and react prompting. These prompt engineering techniques often require the decorating of a base question with further text to stimulate this emergent property of LLMs to acquire new skills at inference time. This, in turn, has led to the development of frameworks like LangChain. Among many other useful components, LangChain has a series of prompt modules to store the text required to decorate these base queries with the necessary text to turn the base queries into effective prompts using one of the techniques mentioned. Tree of Thought is a prompting technique designed to mimic human brainstorming and collaboration, making it ideally suited to mathematical reasoning problems, particularly in the fields of linear algebra, arithmetic, and logic. Again, it's worth remembering that these large language models were not built to solve these types of problems, not at all. But we've seen that with the correct prompt, they're able to effortlessly solve complex problems. It's therefore unsurprising that the discipline of prompt engineering is such an exciting and popular one. The authors of Tree of Thoughts prompting sought to use the property of language models to learn at inference time as a way of mimicking the brainstorming capability of humans. In a brainstorming session, participants are encouraged to come up with several candidate ideas to solve a problem and collectively critique diverse solutions to identify promising candidates. These candidate ideas are then further developed and critiqued, until the group collectively arrives at an optimal solution. Imagine a tree. Each branch represents a thought, and the entire tree symbolizes the journey towards a solution. That's the essence of Tree of Thoughts prompting. In order to achieve this, the developers of Tree of Thoughts suggested generating these branches through a formal process. They used some work done on AI back in the 1950s as the basis for this approach. This formal process breaks down into four steps. 1. Thought decomposition. 2. Thought generation. 3. State evaluation. And finally, search algorithm. Let's begin with thought decomposition. In this step, we break down a problem into smaller, manageable thought steps. This could be a few words, a line of an equation, or even a paragraph, depending on the complexity of the problem at hand. Next, we have the thought generator. Here we take the current state of our problem and generate potential thoughts or next steps. The key is diversity and adaptability. The more potential diverse solutions we have, the more we're likely to find the best outcome. Once we have these potential thoughts, we need a way to evaluate them. Enter the state evaluator. This serves as our guide. determining which states or branches of thoughts are promising and should be explored further. Finally, we have a search algorithm. Depending on the problem at hand, we can use different strategies like breadth-first search or depth-first search. These determine the path our problem-solving process will take through the tree of thoughts. With the tree of thoughts, we have a flexible, adaptable, and modular approach to problem solving. The key idea is to explore multiple reasoning paths or thoughts, something conventional language models couldn't previously do. Remember, like a tree, problem solving is about growth and exploration. So I've applied these principles and process to generate my own tree of thoughts prompt decorator, which you can see here. Feel free to pause the video and ponder this prompt. Please also feel free to use this in your own tree of thoughts experiments, but more importantly, modify it to see the change in outcomes that result from a change in this prompt template. We ask the AI to consider three branches of thought and for each thought to be thorough in analysis. We encourage collaboration and diligence on the intermediate thoughts generated. We ask for this process to evolve, to identify dead ends and to backtrack if a solution finds itself in a dead end. We ask for state evaluation and final synthesis of answers. With that prompt in mind, let's provide a logic problem, simple enough for humans to solve, but challenging for LLMs, as we shall see. Let's follow Carlos, a hapless aquaphile. He visits the locker room at a swimming pool and places his watch in his towel. He carries his towel to a lounger and perhaps wishes to lounge around for a while and take in the atmosphere and soak up the sun. However, he realizes he's hungry. This takes him away from the lounger and towards the snack bar, where the food entices him. But then he remembers that you shouldn't go into the water on a full stomach. And after all, he came here to swim. So he heads to the pool via the diving board. Upon emerging from the pool, he realizes that he has lost his watch. So where do you think Carlos's watch ended up? Keep this in mind as we go through the tree of thoughts prompting process, and we'll reveal what our AI predicts at the end. Let's try out ChatGPT on this problem. If we treat this as a simple IO problem, then ChatGPT, at least the 3.5 Da Vinci 3 model, pretty much always says it's at the snack bar. This is where he left the towel. Try it for yourself using ChatGPT. The scenario I've described, the text is in the description. However, if we decorate this text with the Tree of Thoughts prompt decorator, also in the description, we arrive at a very different result. Here, expert one doesn't seem to have identified a key element, which is the vigorous shaking of the towel at the lounger. But expert one is at least open to the fact that the key might have fallen out. Expert 2 seems to be a budding Sherlock Holmes. Her powers of deductive reasoning seem very sharp. While Expert 3 seems to be somewhat aligned with Expert 1. While this is not the optimum start with only 1 out of 3 on the right track, we see the power now of the review and critique by all the experts of the diverse reasoning. Expert 2 has managed to uncover the key element, no pun intended, of the vigorous shaking. Once presented to the other budding detectives, Expert 2's train of thought wins the day. Now, there is nothing special or sacred about this Tree of Thoughts prompt decorator that I've presented. I encourage you to make changes to it and run it for yourselves, both on the Carlos's lost watch problem and other problems of your own invention. The only reason I use 3 experts is that's the number in the original paper, but it's trivial to invoke more experts with a simple change to the prompt. Here, I've changed the train of thoughts prompt decorator by randomly removing one line. This is the line that said, quote, "Then all experts will go on to the next step and write down this step of their thinking," end quote. This results in a slightly different outcome. While the experts more or less agree on the lounger as the most likely location, in this scenario, they're more open to other locations, specifically between the lounger and the snack bar, and the snack bar itself. Again, please feel free to pause and rewind the video to take in the verbal commentary from the experts. And more importantly, try this yourself with your own prompts and scenarios. Now, it should be pointed out that with GPT-4, Tree of Thoughts does not seem necessary for this problem. If you have access to GPT-4, compare the difference between it and prior versions, like 3.5, which do need Tree of Thoughts for this scenario. I also tried Chain of Thoughts prompting, and while this was not unsuccessful, in my small sample, it had a 25% success rate. Again, please do experiment with different scenarios and chain of thoughts prompts of your own. From our deep dive into the Tree of Thoughts prompting technique, we've seen how AI can brainstorm like a human, coming up with various solutions and choosing the most promising one. With GPT-4, this process can become even more powerful. Now it's over to you. Experiment with your own prompts and scenarios, and let's continue to explore this fascinating field together. Remember to share your results and experiences in the comments below. We're excited to hear from you, particularly if they differ from my own. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell for more cutting-edge AI content from Lucidate.